Many people have the misconception that Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is the founder of the religion of Islam. In fact, Islam is there since time immemorial. It's there since man set foot on the earth. And the Holy Quran says in Surah Fatir, chapter number 35, verse number 24, it says, وَإِمْ مِنْ أُمَّةٍ إِلَّا خَلَافِهَا نَذِيرٍ. There is not a nation or a tribe to whom we have not sent a warner or a guide. The Quran says in Surah Rab, chapter number 13, verse number 7, وَلِكُلِّ قَوْمٍ هَادٍ. And to every nation we have sent a warner. By name, the Holy Quran mentions 25 messengers by name. For example, Adam, Moses, Jesus, Solomon, Muhammad, peace be upon them all. But according to the tradition of a beloved prophet, there were more than 124,000 messengers sent on the face of the earth. The Quran says in Surah Nisa, chapter 4, verse number 164, as well as in Surah Ghafir, chapter number 40, verse number 78, that we relate to you the stories of some of the messengers, of the others we don't. That means, some messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have been mentioned in the Holy Quran. The others have not been mentioned. All the messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of God Almighty, that came before Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, they were only meant for a particular group of people. They were only sent for a particular group of people. And the message which they brought was only meant for a particular time period. It was not till eternity. The Holy Quran says that Musa alayhi salam, Moses peace be upon him, he was only sent for the Bani Israel, for the children of Israel. The Quran says in Surah Al-Imran, chapter number 3, verse number 49, that Jesus peace be upon him was sent as a messenger to the Bani Israel, to the children of Israel. He was only sent for the Jews. A similar message is given in the Bible, in the Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 10, verse number 5 to 6, where Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, tells his disciples, his apostles, that go ye not into the way of the Gentiles. Who are the Gentiles? The non-Jews. Go ye not into the way of the Gentiles, and enter ye not into the city of the Samaritans, but rather go to the house of the lost sheep of Israel. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said, it's mentioned in the Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 15, verse number 24, that I have not been sent but to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. So Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, was only sent for the Jews. But the Holy Quran says, and I started my talk by quoting a verse of the Holy Quran from Surah Ahzab, chapter number 33, verse number 40, which says, مَا كَانَ مُحَمَّدٌ مَا كَانَ مُحَمَّدٍ أَبَا أَهَدٍ مِنْ رِجَالِكُمْ وَلَاكِ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ وَخَاتَمُ النَّبِيِّينَ وَقَانَ اللَّهُ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمًا. That Muhammad, peace be upon him, is not the father of any of you men, but is the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and is خَاتَمُ النَّبِيِّينَ, is the seal of the prophets, and Allah is all-knowing, full of knowledge. The Holy Quran says, that Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is the last of the prophets and messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Quran says in Surah Al-Anbiya, chapter number 21, verse number 107, it says, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. That we have sent thee not but as a mercy to all the creatures, as a mercy to all the world, as a mercy to the whole of humankind. So Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, he was not sent only to the Muslims or the Arabs, he was sent to the whole of humankind. The Quran says in Surah Sabah, chapter number 34, verse number 28, it says, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا كَافَّةً لِلنَّاسِ بَشِيرًا وَنَذِيرًا. That we have sent thee as a universal messenger, giving glad tidings to men and warning them against sin. But the most of them yet do not understand. Since the Holy Quran says that Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is the last and final messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he was sent for the whole of humankind, all the Muslims, alhamdulillah, will agree with it. But since a non-Muslim does not believe that the Holy Quran is the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will not agree that Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is a last and final prophet of God Almighty and is sent for the whole of humankind. So to make them realize this, we have to take the help of the Holy Quran, which says in Surah Al-Imran, chapter number 3, verse number 64, which says that Ta'ala ila kalmatin sawa'in bainana wa bainakum, that come to common terms as between us and you. So since the non-Muslims will not believe in the Holy Quran, we have to prove to them about the advent of our beloved Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, from their holy scriptures. So let's analyze today Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, in the various religious scriptures of the world. So let's discuss the prophecy of our beloved Prophet in the Jewish and the Christian scriptures. The Holy Bible is divided into two parts, the Old Testament and the New Testament. The Old Testament deals with the stories of all the prophets that came before Jesus, peace be upon him. And the New Testament deals with the life of the messenger, Jesus, peace be upon him. If you read the Holy Bible of the Catholics, the dual version, it has got 73 books. If you read the other edition, Good News Bible, it has 81 books. But the main dual version has got 73 books. The Bible of the Protestants has only 66 books. They say that 7 books from the Old Testament, they are apocryphal. They apocryphal. The masses of the people don't understand the meaning of apocryphal. It means doubtful. So therefore the Protestant Christians, they don't believe in these 6 books. So the Old Testament of the Catholics contains 46 books. The Old Testament of the Protestants, it contains 39 books. The New Testaments of both contain 27 books. The Holy Quran says in Surah Araf, chapter number 7, verse number 157, that the Jews and Christians, they follow a messenger, the unlettered prophet, which is mentioned in the law and the gospel. So if you read the Old Testament, in the book of Deuteronomy, chapter number 18, verse number 18, it says, God Almighty says, that I shall raise thee up a prophet from among thy brethren, like unto thee, and I shall put my words into his mouth, and he shall speak all that I command him. If you ask the Christian that who does this prophecy refer to, he will say it refers to Jesus, peace be upon him. And to make it fit Jesus, peace be upon him, he will say that see, since Moses, peace be upon him, was a prophet, even Jesus, peace be upon him, was a prophet. Since Moses, peace be upon him, was a Jew, even Jesus, peace be upon him, was a Jew. So this prophecy fits to no one but Jesus, peace be upon him. The prophecy says he should be like Moses. If these two are the only criteria, that the person should be a prophet and should be a Jew, then all the prophets mentioned in the Bible after Prophet Moses, peace be upon him, like Solomon, Ezekiel, Isaiah, Daniel, Hosea, Joel, John the Baptist, may peace be upon them all these prophets fulfilled the prophecy because all were Jewish and all of them were prophets of God Almighty. In fact, if you analyze, this prophecy fits to no one better than our beloved Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Because Moses, peace be upon him, and Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, both of them, they had mother and father. Prophet Jesus, peace be upon him, was born miraculously, without any male intervention. He only had a mother, he had no father. So Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is more like Moses, peace be upon him. And Jesus, peace be upon him, is unlike Moses, peace be upon him. Both Moses and Muhammad, peace be upon them, they were married and had children. According to the Bible, Jesus, peace be upon him, was not married, neither did he have any children. Both Moses and Muhammad, peace be upon them, they died a natural death. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, according to the Holy Quran, he was raised up alive. According to the false reading of the Bible, they say he was crucified on the cross. Anyway, he did not die a natural death. Both Moses and Muhammad, peace be upon them, they brought new laws. Jesus, peace be upon him, brought no new law. It's mentioned in the Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 5, verse number 17, that think not I have come to destroy the law and the prophets. I have come not to destroy, but to fulfill. So according to the Bible, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, says that he brought no new law.